Steve Jobs biography. The founder of Apple. Steve Jobs is the founder of the digital innovation, and we also find him a perfectionist in his field. In 2010, the net worth of Steve was $8 billion. In the field of technology, his name is at the top and no one can beat him. He's not only rich but also very creative and risk-taker. People call him the global icon because he can shake the technology. The whole world admires his work due to his products. Steve started low, from his garage, and now his company was worth more than $742 billion. For over 30 years, there was a great transformation in the world of music, mobile phones, computers, and movies, just because of Apple. That is Steve Jobs' creation. Now, we will explore his journey like his biography. Steve Jobs was born in San Francisco, California, in a poor home. His parents could not afford him, so a couple adopted him. His real parents wanted him to get higher education, but he had no interest in studies. Though he was very intelligent, but he never liked going to school. In 1970, during his teenage years, Steve used to play with computers and phones and discovered new business plan. Steve used to play with computers and phones and discovered new business plans. Now everybody knows that he was dropped out of his college, and this is when his successful journey started. At the age of 21, Steve developed a company with his friend Steve Wozniak and invented the Apple computer. Both of them started with Steve Jobs' family garage. Steve sold his Volkswagen bus to support his business, whereas Wozniak sold his favorite calculator. These two guys gave us new technology with smart and cheaper devices, which are also copied by some countries. Wozniak created a user-friendly PC, and Jobs used to market it. In the beginning, Apple was sold at $666 each, and that was Apple I. Their first success motivated them to create bigger machines, better than the previous ones. At the end of 1970, they developed Apple II. That became a big hit. Apple II was better at speed than the previous model, and this is how they became millionaires, by selling computers in the whole United States of America. But after that, he had to face some challenges when he hired John Sculley, the former Pepsi's chief executive, and wanted to expand Apple. But Sculley and Jobs could not get along with each other because Jobs was more demanding, and both separated after 2 years. Interestingly, Steve was fired from his own company, which made him very aggressive, that we can see in all his career. After a year, Steve bought a less successful animation studio from George Lucas, the creator of Star Wars. Steve spent a lot of money on this studio for 10 years when it created a hit movie in 1997 named Toy Story. Then Steve developed another company named Next that had high-tech workstations. However, it failed commercially. But after a decade, Apple was bought by Steve. That was his own creation. For a few years, Jobs worked for Apple as an interim CEO and then worked full-time. And this was his second phase at Apple. This was the time when Steve developed famous devices like iPad and iMac, which made Apple even bigger than before in technology. Though Steve had to pass through a lot to reach here, the challenges he faced made him stronger. He learned from his failures and his experiences made him more successful. Then in 2019, some news came about Steve's weight loss, and Steve told people that he had a hormonal imbalance. He remained out of news for a year. Then on September 9, 2009, he attended an event by Apple. On October 1, 2010, Steve passed away because of pancreatic cancer. He was 56 years old when he died. Before his death, he told people that he found him lucky because he did what he loved and started his journey at 20. He had a sudden success after inventing the computer, but his failures made him lighter. He believed that he survived only because he loved his work. He stated that the work can satisfy you only if you love it. If you don't know what makes you happy, then explore it, unfind, and never give up. Even the biggest companies like Google and Microsoft could not make him feel low. Instead, he kept on doing the hard work. He always wanted Apple to remain at the top. Steve is the biggest inspiration for all entrepreneurs who consider him their hero.